Alright guys, so we are back with some more DDLC Purist Mod. As we are continuing to finish Sayori's ending, which I think we're about to be at the end here. So, I can't wait to see this ending though. I'm really so happy. Alright, I walk back to her and try to kiss her, but to my surprise, she stops me. Also, let me just point out, where we left off last episode was, she did find the noose when we threw it out of her window, and then we said that because we're in love with her, instead of saying we're just trying to help her, because that kind of sounds douchey to say that. Plus, we do love her. Come on, everybody loves her. If you say you don't love her, you're lying. You're lying. I'm not sure if I should. I have so many thoughts and feelings surging through me right now. Oh. Hey, wait. I forgot about this. Oh, yeah. We have, like, that flyer, too, for something that's about to happen at the park. Right? Yeah, at the park. For the park. Thing. I dig through my pocket and take out the flyer that hit me earlier. Oh, that looks fun. Yeah, we could do that. Maybe it'd help us both relax. Today was needlessly tense, wasn't it? Yeah. I'm sorry, but I promise I'll change and become better for your sake. Aw, Sayori. No, not for your sake. I love you, but I'm not sure if I love myself. But if I don't love myself, how can I ever feel comfortable being in a relationship with you? Aww. She scans me with her eyes as we walk back into her house. Mikey, could we just act like nothing ever happened for the next few hours? I just want to give my brain some time to process what happened.
I hug her.
She hugs me back tightly.
Of course, take all the time you need.
Do you want me to leave as well?
No. I want you to stay right here with me.
Huh?
I want to make the relationship official.
Ah, be official! They're gonna go out to the public!
But I think my brain needs some more time to get used to thinking of you as my boyfriend. So I'd like to have one last evening where we're just friends. And then
a mischievous smile pops up in her face.
After that, I want to ask you out, just like I always wanted to when we were younger.
Aw, I nod. Okay, I like that idea.
You're the best. Alright, just wait here for a bit. I'm going to make you dinner tonight.
I feel sweat rolling down my forehead.
Just don't burn the house like I nearly did that one time. Don't worry, I won't. I've been practicing.
With that, she takes off into the kitchen. The vibrant energy, the outburst of positivity. This is the Sayori I used to know. No, I still know her. Deep down, I know this is her true personality. Even if I'm wrong, and her real personality is the depressed girl, I still love her regardless. And I never want to let her go. Not now, not ever. We didn't even bother changing out of our school uniforms before we headed out. Around 11:30, we arrive at the park. We arrive at the park where we went on our first date. It feels like ages since that day. Sayori and I hold hands, and I can feel her newfound motivation and vitality without even looking at her. Her hands are even warmer than before.
Looks like the fireworks will be starting soon. Let's find a place where we could sit and watch them.
Leave it to me.
I love how reliable you are.
I nod towards her and flash her a smile. I guess this is our official first date, huh?
Yes, or, well, just wait and see, okay?
Okay. After spending some time searching, we come across an empty table with two chairs.
Looks like we found our seats for the show.
And just in time, too. As soon as she sits down, the sky is lit up by countless fireworks.
Wow, it's beautiful.
I sit down next to her, wrapping my arms around her to keep her warm. She does the same to me. I don't know whether it's from her touch or not, but I feel like keeping her close makes me warm on the inside.
Aww. I'm so happy I can enjoy these fireworks with you.
I feel the same.
Hey, Mikey?
Huh?
I've been thinking about us and our relationship. I want to make it official. I don't want to hide it anymore.
I thought you said that just like a few minutes ago.
I just wanted to make sure if you're okay with this.
I want to make it official as well. But if we're going to do that, I take our hands into mine. Let's do it properly. I stare into her eyes.
Mikey, will you please be my boyfriend?
Sayori, will you please be my girlfriend? Did they just say that at the same time or something? Sayori's eyes become filled with tears of joy. We said the words at the exact same time. It was. That's fucking cute, honestly. They like try to ask each other out at the same time. That is so fucking cute.
I'm so happy, Mikey. This is all thanks to you.
I promise I'll never let you down again.
You never let me down. And I know you never will.
Just as our lips part, a loud bang is heard above us. Oh, wow, that's cool. We turn our eyes to the sky and see a rainbow-colored firework above, blow from above, whatever.
That's a sign. It's got to be a sign that things will get better. Hey, Mikey?
Hmm? She looks at me with a deeply affectionate stare and strokes the back of my head.
I'll do everything I can to make you happy as your girlfriend.
You've already made me happy. You do so every day.
Aww.
You being alive and being with me every day is enough to make me happy.
Oh, I'm gonna cry. And from now on, I promise to spend every day making you even happier. Because from now on, I'll try to make both of us happy. I don't want to be selfish, but...
Sometimes you need to be selfish in order to be selfless. Is that really how it goes? Just don't overdo it, okay?
I won't. Especially since I know you'll be with me all the way and make sure I don't mess up.
It makes me happy to do that. I really love you, Sayori.
And I really love you back, Mikey.
Ah, I'm gonna cry. It's too fucking sweet. I ship these two so much.
Even if I still feel you're too good for someone like me, I'm starting to feel genuine happiness from knowing you love me. At first I was so afraid, but not anymore. You give me courage, and I'm enjoying the feeling of knowing that my love is mutual.
From now on, let's make every single day awesome.
You got it.
Sarah and I hug each other tightly.
Oh yeah. There's another thing, Mikey.
What is it? She purses her lips and takes a deep breath before continuing.
I decided that I'm going to tell the others about my depression.
Aw, good for you, Sayori. That's only your choice, and you're finally going to go for it.
After thinking about what you said, I realized that it's wrong of me to keep running away like that. If nothing else, me being open about it could save me some stress down the line.
Are you sure, Sayori? She nods.
I know it's going to be hard for me. I feel
her tighten her grip around my wrist.
But I've got you by my side. Aww, that's all I need.
These two are so fucking cute, I love it.
And the others at the literature club need to know. I don't want them to worry about me, and they're my friends as well.
Sayori.
Can I just ask a favor of you?
What do you need me to do?
Please be there with me when I tell them. And if I hesitate, I want you to be the one to reveal the truth to them.
Are you absolutely sure about this? You know that if we do that, things will never return to normal. Siri laughs dryly.
I'm afraid that ship sailed a long time ago. It sailed when I told you I feel about you, and when we became a couple. But it's all right. I don't miss it as much as I thought I would. The only way I can go is forward, right?
Yeah.
No matter how much one might want it, the past will always remain in the past.
And even when I speak of the present time, it's also fallen into the past as I speak of it. So the only way forward is the future. Siri nods.
Then that's what I'll focus on. A bright future together with you. And if I want that, I have to cut my ties with the past. Just like when we burned the rope, I want to stop pretending like everything is fine just to please others. Since I can make them genuinely happy if I also feel happy.
I'm amazed at how you've grown.
It's all thanks to you. It's because I had the best boyfriend in the world.
That's it? No way, that's it. Alright, so apparently there is another scene in the game, apparently, that involves Sayori at the end. Which, I don't get why I didn't get that scene, but as I was scrolling through, I knew something wasn't right about this, about the ending, that it shouldn't have ended just like that. So apparently there is another scene to it, but I have no idea why I didn't get it, but anyway, we're gonna watch it, and we'll react to it. I'm going to point out that this video was made by Grenade of Taco, so credits to him. I'll put this video in the description, and you can check out his actual full playthrough with Sayori's route right there. So, yeah. Gotta take a look. We might be pausing a bunch of times to read the dialogue, so. Several months have passed, and the new year's begun. As promised, Sayori told her friends in the literature club about her deep depression. With my help, that is. I still remember the conversation that day. She tried to tell them, but broke down in tears halfway through.
Aww.
In the end, I finished the confession in her place.
Wow. I didn't know. Sayori, is there anything we can do to help?
The expression on Monica's face as Sayori confessed. It was solemn, but at the same time, she looked happy.
You can always talk to me, Sayori. I'll do all I can as the president of the literature club to help you get through this. Although I have a feeling that you already have someone who can help you much better than me.
Isn't that right, Kenny? I think his character's name is Kenny. So, should I just replace it by saying my character's name, or should I just read what it says here? Does it really matter? I don't know. I guess I'll probably do back and forth.
Kenny!
Oh, so that's why you two acted like even bigger dorks than usual.
You two are a couple?
I see. So my hunch was correct after all.
Bitch.
I hope you two are happy together. So I guess you two will be writing all sorts of sappy, lovey-dovey poems from now on, huh? Wouldn't that be fun to see? Kenny writing a love poem. The thought is enough to make me laugh.
It'll be interesting, that's for sure.
Oh, come on, I'm not that awful. Besides, I'll have Sayori to help me. So you better watch out, Monica. Next time we have our festival, our poem will be the best one. I'm looking forward to it. You know, in the competition with Monica.
Does that mean you won't quit?
Nope, I'm here to stay. Heh, you better not slack off just because you're in a relationship now. I won't, don't worry. And Sayori, you can always count on the three of us, too.
Indeed. If you ever have a problem, you can count on me.
Same here. I hear sugar helps against depression. If you want to, I can always throw another cupcake your way. That's nice of her, surprisingly.
Kenny, thanks. I feel as if a huge weight has been lifted from my shoulders.
Don't forget, this was just the easy part. Now you have to tell the rest of your class. And you'll have to do it without me. Are you sure you can handle it?
Don't worry, I know I can. Even if they end up judging me, I don't care. You still love me for who I am.
Always, Sayori.
And my friends in the literature club accept me, despite me lying to them. So I know I can manage.
Over the course of the next few months, both our lives improved. Even though Sayori was forced to tell her family, they took it better than she thought they would. They all pooled their money together and hired a very skilled psychiatrist. Over time, I could see Sayori's depression getting weaker and weaker. And by the time the new year came around, I noticed almost all traces of it disappearing. As for me, I became much more outgoing and active as part of Sayori's therapy. I attend every single psychiatry session with Sayori, helping her find the correct words and offering support.
Oh, that's nice.
Eventually, the psychiatrist suggested that we both become more active and exercise more often. I don't know whether it's thanks to his expertise or my loving support and patience. How about both? But soon, Sayori returned to the way she always was.
Yay!
And this time, I know for sure that her smile and energy are genuine. Fast forward a few months. Oh my god. It's Valentine's Day! Jeez. How ironic that the one day I always hated would be the day I would be the most excited for this year. As I sit down at the table, anxiously tapping my foot against the floor, I think about how lucky I am to spend this Valentine's Day with Sayori. I need to turn on the volume a little bit more. It's a bit loud compared to in the game. The girl who makes every day feel worthwhile and who inspires me to become a better man. Every time I think about her, a silly smile creeps up on my face. Ever since the day when the two of us burned the rope, our love has only grown every day, or each day. We trust each other completely, and she's the only person I'm comfortable being myself around. Sorry, hold up. I'm gonna have to cut this part out. Even if both of us are clumsy and make mistakes, I know she loves me for my flaws. Wait, we're clumsy? I guess the festival performance kind of means we were clumsy. Just like I love her for hers. And that's how I want it to continue for many years to come. I don't want to tell her yet, since I don't want to get her hopes up. But once I get a stable job and a good source of income, I will ask her to marry me. I thought about it for a while and have come to realize that she is the girl I've always wanted to be with. My thoughts are interrupted by a knock at the door. I can't help but laugh. Sayori has a copy of the key to my house that she still knocks on the door every time. It's open. Come on in, Sayori. The door opens, and the smell of the perfume I gave her for Christmas fills the room. Is it Axe body spray?
Oh, right. I forgot I had the key. Are you ready, Kenny? I'm trying out a new style, like I promised.
I'm waiting.
I can't help myself. It's so cute. Oh my goodness. Wow. Did you like it? Even more beautiful than I remember. How come you become prettier every time I see you?
I'm so happy. Alright, here. I made the chocolate myself. I really hope I didn't mess up or anything.
She hands me the chocolate. Why don't you sit down so we can enjoy it together? Sayori cheerfully smiles and hums as she sits down next to me, resting her head against my shoulder.
Aww.
She watches in anticipation as I unwrap the box. The box is filled with heart-shaped chocolates. And she made it? Wow.
Aw, look at her. Look how cute she looks. Oh my god.
I can't stand her. She's such a cute video game character and anime character and whatnot. She's so cute. I take one out and hand it to Sayori before taking hold of her hand. I thought it'd be cuter if we took the first bite together. Sayori blushes and we eat the chocolate together. Halfway through, our lips meet and we kiss.
Aww. What'd you think?
That chocolate was amazing. Your cookie has improved so much.
Well, I had the best teacher in the world. And also, I had more motivation than anyone. I want to make you happy, since every time I see you're happy when we are together, it makes my heart beat so much faster and motivates me to keep making you happy.
Aww.
Since you make me so happy, and that's why I kept pushing the rain clouds away.
We hug each other so tight, I can feel our heartbeat.
In fact, about that...
She pauses for a while.
Yeah.
According to psychiatrists, I'm close to making a full recovery.
From depression? Depression doesn't go away, Sayori.
I know that's impossible.
Hey, well, now she knows. Alright.
But in all honesty, I don't feel it anymore. The rain clouds are gone. I occasionally feel the odd wave of sadness, but it also goes away when I think about spending time with you.
Aww.
These two are so cute together. I love them. The freaking NC and Sayori. I just said Sayori.
It's because you were there for me all the time. You always treated me like an equal, and your actions made me realize that as long as you're here and I can be sure of our relationship, there's no way I can ever allow myself to give up.
Sayori.
Kenny, what's wrong? Are you crying?
No. No. I'm not. You're crying.
I don't realize it until she points it out, but tears are running down my face. Sayori gently wipes them away and... Oh, fuck. I need to push that. But whatever. I think I'm just so happy and relieved.
Please don't cry. You know I'm a sympathetic crier. And I don't want to cry anymore. I'm going to face each day with a smile. Be it sunshine or rain outside. You know why? Oh, another close-up. Because I love you, Kenny. I always love you. And your love for me makes me accept myself. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much.
Fantastic ending. Fan-fucking-tastic. Oh my god, I am actually tearing. Oh my god. Oh my god. I'm tearing so much because it was so fucking cute and sweet ending. Oh my god.
Oh man, I wish I got this cutscene too. Fuck.
actually tearing. I'm crying. Oh, God. I had a feeling eventually I was going to start crying from this fucking mod. Jesus Christ. Man, if everyone's going to get an ending like this, I'm probably going to cry, like, every ending. But literally so far, Sayori's is so fucking cute and adorable. It's like, she has so much motivation now. It's so fucking nice. Like, oh man. I can't believe I'm actually crying right now. Oh shit. This was so nice though. Like, oh my god. Wow, I am totally speechless though. That is a remarkable ending. Like, wow. My god. Oh shit. Alright, well, that's it for this ending, so I guess the next one we're gonna do is Natsuki's. And probably lastly Yuri, if she is the last one. I don't know if Monica gets an ending in this, but we'll find out eventually. So yeah, I cried on camera, and right now, since this is the only ending we've gotten so far in this mod, but this is by far the best ending right now. I don't know if anyone else is going to have anything similar, but if they don't, Sayori's ending is going to be the best one in this mod. So yeah, that's it. I'll see you guys in the next video.